Okay, so in last class we have discussed about the calculation of deflection of a simply supported beam with the point loads. Okay, in today's class we are going to look at the calculation of deflection of the same simply supported beam with a point load. That is a difference. Okay, so there is a small change in the proceeding, but all other steps are very similar. Okay, so before I tell you the change, let us calculate the reaction first. I told you here initially your reactions at A and B are not known. That you have to calculate. So to calculate the reactions at A and B, so I apply my equilibrium equation. Summation of force along y direction is zero. So by doing so, I can write RA plus RB. Say reaction at A is RA, reaction at B is RB. Okay, that should be equal to the applied load. So what is applied load? This is the applied load, that is a UDL, uniformly distributed load. It is distributed to the length of 4 meters. Okay, then what will be the total load? This 40 kilonewton load is distributed to the length of 4 meters. Okay, but here rate of loading is 40 kilonewton per meter. For 1 meter, it is distributed in the range of 40 kilonewton. Then what is the total length? That is 4 meters. Then how can I obtain the total value of load? That I can obtain by multiplying 40 by 4. Okay, so I'll get 160. Okay, so now you can apply the other equation of equilibrium, that is moment about any point, say A is zero. So when I take moment about this point, I will get two loads. One is RB, that is right side acting upward. So I take RB positive. RB is at the distance from A as 8 meters. So RB into 8 meters minus 40 into, because it is acting downward, it is tend to rotate the beam in the clockwise direction. So I take minus, as I took anti-clockwise and negative direction. So minus 40 into the distance between this UDL to the point A. So how will you consider that? First of all, you have to convert this 40 into a point load, 40 kilonewton per meter into a point load. How will you do that? By multiplying these two, that is 160 kilonewton. That will be acting at the centroid of this length. The length of a centroid will be at the center. So 160 kilonewton is acting at 2 meter from this point. Okay, so then what is the total distance? That is 140 into 4 into 3. 3 is the, because 1 meter here, 2 meter here, 2 plus 1, 3. Okay, 40 into 4 is nothing but the conversion of UDL into point load. So you get it. And there is no other load, so equate it to zero. So if you calculate, you will get RB as 60 kilonewton. Okay, when you substitute the RB in equation one, you will get RA as 100 kilonewton. Okay, so RB and RA values, we have calculated reaction values, we have calculated. Okay, so now we are going to proceed with the usual procedure of finding the moment equation, general moment equation. I told you for the deflection problems, you have to imagine the plane at the leftmost segment. What is the leftmost segment? BD, CD, AC. AC is the leftmost segment. Okay, so I imagine a plane at leftmost segment, XX plane, at a distance of X from my origin. So what is my origin? My origin is nothing but my right end, that is B. Okay, so now in this case, particularly for calculating the deflection of simply supported beam, when you are provided with the UDL like this, okay, whereas your UDL is not distributed up to the end, it is only distributed up to this intermediate region, that is CD. Okay, so in this case, listen very carefully, you have to do one small assumption. So what is that assumption? In the sense, you have to assume, okay, A continuing distributed load of same rate 40 kilonewton in the top and bottom of this extended region. 40 kilonewton from this side, kilonewton per meter from this side, and are they same 40 kilonewton from the bottom? Okay, so now what happened? This 40 kilonewton per meter and this 40 kilonewton per meter will tally each other because it is acting downward, it is acting upward. So they act in equal magnitude but opposite in direction. So what is not going to change? The net moment or net force that is acting on the beam is not going to change. But why do we assume so? That is a question. So why we should assume that this 40 kilonewton load from the point C to A is extended? When we develop the moment equation, when we develop the moment equation for the plane XX located at the distance of X, we have to consider the distributed load. But what we will do, as this load is not extended up to this X point, okay, we will try to convert this as a point load and we will consider that as a point load in case of bending moment, tying the bending moment diagram. Whereas your expression for the deflection works in a different way. Okay, so if you consider that as a point load, then your the expression for that you are developing for deflection will be only applicable for that CD region, which will not be used for applying to calculate the deflection that happened in any point located in the AC segment. Okay, so the reason for assuming this extension of the distributed load is to have a common general equation of moment, okay, to calculate the moment even at this AC segment, sorry, deflection even at this DC AC segment. Okay, so ipo na idu extend pannana enna irum enoda load value thappa irum because idu varaikum the actual case la 40 kilonewton act aayirukku inge vandu act agala appo na inge vandu extend pannana idu nullify pandradhukku na enna pananum keela irundum 40 kilonewton act agra mari assume pananum appo enna irum inda 40 kilonewton inda 40 kilonewton it will get tally. Okay, so in the assumption edhukku pandrom appadina, this assumption is done to create a general equation which is also applicable for AC segment, not to be stopped with C point. Okay, so that is the main intention. So now after this assumption, everything is else is same as like your previous problem. You can start to write the moment equation and then you can derive the expression for the slope and deflection, and then you can apply the boundary condition, you can find the constants, and after that you can find the values of deflection and slope at any desired point. Okay, but only thing is that if you have a UDL like this, okay, so if you are going to imagine the XX plane in this region, then you have to extend this uniformly distributed load until the point A. And if you are extending that load, to compensate that load, you should also apply the load from the, or assume the load from the bottom to nullify that load. Okay, so now the net load or moment that is acting on the beam is not changed. The net load are because 40 kilonewton from the top, 40 kilometers from the bottom, so this is getting zero almost. Okay, but why we assume that? Only to create a general equation which is applicable for the entire length. Okay, that you should understand very carefully. Okay, so now I'm going to proceed the problem with the usual things that I'm going to write the moment equation for to create general moment equation okay so I'm going to create the general moment equation okay so how will you write the moment equation you know that so now you see you are imagining a plane xx at the distance of x from the origin So now if you look at the right side, how many forces you have? You have two forces. One is your UDL, another one is your point load, that is your reaction. Okay, so the first you can write the reaction, that is RB. What is RB? That is 60 kilonewton. So this is 60 kilonewton, this is 100 kilonewton. RA is 100 kilonewton. So right side 60 is acting in the upward direction, trying to rotate your beam in the counterclockwise direction. So 60, I take it as a positive value. So 60 into X, and then I have a point load. You look at that. Now the point load, distributed load, the distributed load is two portion is there. One is acting downward, another one is acting upward. Okay, so upward is acting only in the AC region, downward is acting between A to D region. Why it is A to D region? Because in CD region we have the actual load, but in AC region we have the assumption of upward and downward load, so that you have upward and downward force in the AC segment. Okay, total upward segment force pathena, it is distributed from A point to D point. Okay, but rate of loading is same rate of loading, that is 40 kilonewton per meter. Okay, then what you can say, you have a, in the right side you have a 40 kilonewton of load, distributed load. Okay, for the distance of x minus 3, because what is x from this imagined plane la irundhu in the origin varaikum x, bd oda distance vandhu 3. So in the distance evlo irukum x la irundhu in the d point varaikum ulla distance la dhaan nama enna panirukom in the distributed load la dhaan nama assume panirukom. So that is x minus 3. Okay, so minus 40 into x minus 3, this is Michaelis bracket, I put Michaelis bracket. Okay, and also now it is the load value. 40 into x minus 3 is the load in which I have my distributed load is acting. Indha point la assume pandren, adanal indha point la irundhu indha point varaikum na vandhu load eduthukuren. X minus 3 da adudaiya total length. Okay, so now I have converted the kilonewton into kilonewton per meter into kilonewton. So now I have to multiply with the distance. So how will I multiply with the distance? I will assume that this UDL is acting at the centroid of this UDL case. The centroid of this UDL case will be at the x minus 3, that is this distance, by 2. Okay, so x minus 3 by 2. Similarly, you can also write it for upward UDL, that is acting at this distance AC. Okay, so how will you write? You have to only consider this length. Okay, so how will you get this length? You can only get this length by multiplying x by subtracting this distance, that is 4 plus 3 7 from x minus 7. Okay, so plus 40 into x minus 7. Okay, again to multiply the perpendicular distance, you have to get x minus 7 by 2. Okay, x minus 7 by 2. So that's all. So nama enna pannitom, I again tell you, we have just done one assumption. So what is that assumption? Is extending the UDL up to the end point. Yeah, eppadi pandrom appadina nama develop pandra equation inda AC segment ku apply aganum abingiradanal appadi pandrom. So idu actually unnoda case la CD ku la dhaan load apply aagirukku, UDL load. Nama AC la nama extend pandradanal இதை நல்லிஃபை பண்ணுறதுக்கு கீழேருந்து ஒரு லோடு ஆக்ட் ஆகணும். ஸோ தட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ ஷுட் பி தட் ஷுட் ஆல்சோ பி இன் த சேம் மேக்னிடியூட். இப்போ மேலேருந்து 40 கிலோ நியூட்டன் பெர் மீட்டர், கீழேருந்து 40 கிலோ நியூட்டன் பெர் மீட்டர். ஓகே, ஸோ இது ரெண்டு என்ன ஆயிரும், இந்த லென்த்தில் டேலி ஆயிரும். ஸோ யூ டோன்ட் ஹாவ் டு ஒரி அபவுட் இட். ஓகே, ஸோ நவ் 40 கிலோ நியூட்டன் மீட்டர் இஸ் ஃபைன். So now what we have to do, the next step, you know that you have framed the moment equation. Now you have to, you know that what is moment, that is EI into d square y by dx square is nothing but your m. Okay, so now you have to go ahead for deriving the y from this d square y by dx square. So you have to differentiate, integrate it two times. Okay, so this you can write it as 40. If you divide these two, you will get 20. Okay, x minus 3 the whole square plus 40 in the 2 cancel panna, you will get 20 x minus 7 the whole square. So this is your reduced expression for moment equation. Now what you can do is you can further integrate it. Okay, so upon integration both sides, what I will get? I will get EI dy by dx 60 into x square by 2 minus 20 into x square panna, I will get x minus 3 the whole cube by 3. The x minus 3 I differentiate panna, you will get 1. The 3 upon 0, x upon 1, so you don't have to write it here. Okay. Similarly, 20 into x minus 7 the whole cube by 3 into 1. Okay. So now this is the one time differentiation, and you will get the constant of integration. You will get the constant of integration, that is C1. Okay. So now this is the kind of slope equation. Now again, you have to integrate on both sides for y. Integrating both sides for y expression. Okay, so EI dy by dx will become y. So now 60 by 2, you will get 30 x cube by 3 minus 20 by 3. Already it is there, and x cube will be x minus 3 the whole power 4 by 4 plus 20 into x minus 7 the whole power 4 by 4. Already you have 3. Okay, plus c1x plus c2. C1 integrate panna, you will get c1x. Second integration constant is c2. Okay, now you have integrated two times. Now what you have to do, you have to find out the value for this constant c1 and c2. How will you find out? You will apply the boundary condition. So apply the boundary condition to find constants c1 and c2. Okay, so what is the first boundary condition? Y will be 0 when x is equal to 0. Okay, because it is a simply supported beam at x is equal to, say this is the x is equal to 0 point. So y is 0 because it is supported here. So this point, there will be no deflection. Similarly, at x is equal to 8, that is the other end of the simply supported beam, at x is equal to 8 also, your y will be 0. Because in that point also we have supported, so there will be no deflection. So these are the two boundary conditions. So in all the problem, you will get the same boundary condition. Y will be 0 at the boundary. Okay. So we are going to apply that in this equation. Y will be 0, okay, when x is 0. So y is 0, na, the left end will be 0. When x is 0, this will be 0. This is a Michaelis bracket. So when you put 0 here, 0 minus 3, you will get, you get a negative. So it is 0. So it is 0. Here, c1x, it is also 0. So c2 value will be 0. Okay, and now if you are going to apply the next case, that is y is equal to 0 when x is equal to 8, so you will get 30 into 8 cube by 3 minus, inge paathana Michaelis bracket la x minus 3 potana, x is equal to 8, if you substitute 8, what you will get? 8 minus 3, you will get 5. Okay, so minus 20 by 3, 8 minus 3, you will get 5, 5 power 4 divided by 4 plus 20 into 8 minus 7, you get a positive value, so you have to keep it 1 power 4 by 12. You can also keep 12 over here, and C2 is 0, C1 into 8. Okay. Let me simplify this. 30 into 8 cube. So now I am simplifying. Okay, so this term gets 5120 minus 20 into I power 4 divided by, you also please work out, 1041.66 plus 20 divided by 12, get 1.66 plus C1 8. Okay, further if you reduce it, you will get the C1 value 5120 minus 1041.66 plus 1.66. okay, you get a positive value. When you take it to the other side, you will get minus 4080 divided by 8, that you will get minus 510. Okay, so this is the C1 value. Okay, so you can work it out and check for the same value, whether you get the same value or not. Okay, so you get a minus 510, that is right. Okay, so now you get C1 and C2 values. So now you can rewrite your equations, rewrite your slope equation and deflection equation. How will you rewrite it? What is your slope equation? EI dy by dx, you can write dy by dx as theta. Okay, 60x square, that is nothing but 30x square minus 20 by 3 x minus 3 the whole cube plus 20 by 12 ne potralam. This is 20 by 12, and here also you get plus 20 by 12 x minus 7 the whole power 4 minus 510 alone, x clear. Okay, because we are writing which equation? Okay, 3 mattum illaya, so that is also not 12, it is only 3. I confused with this. 20 into x minus 3 the whole cube, x minus 7 the whole cube, okay, divided by 3 alone. Okay, so I take only 3. So this is your slope equation, and you write your deflection equation, that is here. Okay, 30 by 3 x cube. Okay, 30 by 3 x cube minus 20 by 12 x minus 3 the whole power 4 plus 20 by 12 x minus 7 the here only 3. Okay, 4 minus 510x. Okay, C2 is 0. So now I have written two equations, that is slope equation and deflection equation. And after this, you have to do the same job as you have done it in the previous cases. Now I want to say, I want to know the deflection at point D and at point C. Say these are the two points where we have the boundary of loads. Okay, so D point is located at 3 meters from my reference. What is my reference starting point? That is this point. From this point, my D is located at 3 meters. Okay, so I substitute at x is equal to 3 meters. What is y? I want to know. That is nothing but y of d. That is nothing but y of d point. Okay, fine. So how can I find out? So ei, that will be there on the left side. Y will become yd. Okay, I want to substitute x equal to 3. Okay, 3 cube divided by 3. Minus inga potenna x equal to 3 potta 3 minus 3 0. Okay, so this term will be 0. And here if you substitute x equal to 3, what will happen? 3 minus 7, you get minus 4. That is negative value that is coming inside the Macaulay bracket. So this will become a 0. Okay, then you will get only 5 10 into, okay, x is 3 meters. 5 10 into 3 meters. Okay, so now you can simplify. 3 cube divided by 3, you will get 270 minus 510 into 3, you get 1530. This is your yd, and you have to divide it by ei. This ei will come this side, na, denominator. No? So what is e? That is 2 into 10 to the power 5 newton per mm square. If you convert that into newton per meter square, because we have substituted all the length in meter. Okay, so it has to be converted as newton per meter square. You will get 2 into 10 to the power 11 newton per meter square. And if you convert I, you will get 1 meter is 10 power minus 3 meter, 1 mm is 10 power minus 3 meter. So you will get 6, 9, 12, minus 12. So minus 12 means you will get minus 4. So 4.3 into 10 power minus 4 meter power 4. I have just converted the unit. Okay. So Okay, so now it is in kilonewton. You know that I told you, for that also you have to add 10 power 3 here, because we have substituted all the loads in kilonewton. So to convert kilonewton into newton, you have to substitute 10 power 3. So now if you simplify the 270 minus 1530, into 10 power 3 divided by 2 into 10 power 11 into 4.3 into 10 power minus 4, you will get minus 0.014. okay, 1465. So meters. If you convert that into mm, you will get yd as minus 14.6 mm. Okay, so this is the deflection at D point. Similarly, you can find out the deflection at and slope at D point. How will you find the slope at D point? The same x is equal to 3, yeah, you will substitute in the slope equation. So theta d will be 30 into x square, that is x square is 3 square. Okay, minus inge vandu 0, this will be 0, this will be 0, you will get only minus 510. So minus 510 minus 510 divided by into 10 power 3 அது மறந்துடாதீங்க 2 into 10 power 11 into 4.3 into 10 power minus 4 போட்டேனா you get 30 into 3 square minus 510 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 2.7 okay minus 2.79 into 10 power minus 3 radian, that is what the slope at D. Okay, similarly you can calculate the slope and deflection for C point. So how will you do that? You will substitute the location of the C in those two equations. RTX is equal to RTX is equal to what is the distance? 3 plus 4, 7 meters. Okay, so 7 meters. So Y of D will be 30 by 3 x cube 7 cube minus 7 minus 3 you get 4 positive, so you will get this term as well. So 20 by 12 7 the whole power 4 inga 7 minus 7 0 so minus 510 into 7 so minus 510 into 7. Okay, so that's all. Sorry, inge vandu 20 by 12. If you substitute 7 meters, 7 minus 3, you get 4. Okay, it is not 7, it is 4. It is 4. And there you only have x, so 7. Okay, so now if you simplify this and divide it by 2 into 10 power 11 into 4.3 into 10 power minus 4, in the sense you will get 30 by 3 into 7 cube minus, so you get 3430 minus 20 into 4 power 4 divided by 12, you get 426.66 minus 510 into 7, you get 3570 by 2 into 10 power 11 into 4.3 10 power minus 4. So okay, now further you can simplify. Okay, 3430 minus 426.66 minus 3570 divided by 2 into 10 power 11 4.3 into 10 power minus 4. Somewhere I committed a mistake. Wait. Oh yeah, 10 power 3. But yeah, you should be very careful. You should not forget 10 power 3. You have to convert the kilonewton into newton. Minus 426.66 minus 3570 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 2 into 10 to the power 11 into 4.3 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, so you get minus 6.58 into 10 power minus 3 meters. Okay, so if you want to write it in mm, you can write it as yd as 6.58 mm. Okay, that's all. So you get the deflection value at d as well. Now if you want to find the theta d value, then you substitute in the theta equation. What is the theta equation? 30x square, that is 30 into 7 square minus 20 by 3 minus 20 by 3 x minus 3. What is x? 7. 7 minus 3, positive 4 cube. 20 by 3, 4 cube. Okay, next term will be 0 and you get minus 510. Get minus 510 divided by 2 into 10 to the power 11, 4.3 into 10 power minus 4. Okay, so when you go for it, you get minus of 20 by 3 into 4 into 5. Minus 10 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 2 into 10 to the power 11, 4.3 into 10 to the power minus 4. You get 10 to the power 3 varo maradha. So theta d will be 6.20 into 10 to the power minus 3 radian. Okay, so these are the two values of deflection and slope for concern point C point and D point. Okay, so these are all the same procedure that we have followed. So the only change is that when you are generating this moment equation, you have to do this assumption of extending this distributed load up to the end. To nullify that extended load, you have to imagine a opposing load in the bottom, in the opposing direction. Okay, so idha vena or note mari eluthi vechukko. So the only change is that extend the distributed load, extend the distributed load to the end and assume a reverse load in the extended length, in the extended length, to nullify the extension force effect. Okay. So after assuming these two, you write the moment equation. After that, all are same procedure as like we have done it in the previous problem. Okay, so now I want to give you a homework. The homework is that now you calculate the maximum deflection for this case. Okay, calculate the maximum deflection for this configuration. I told you when you go for the calculation of maximum deflection, what you have to do, you supposed to assume where the maximum deflection can possibly happen. In the edathula load enga da act aayirukku, C to D la da load act aayirukku, vera endha edathulayum nama actual load illa. Appa enga da maximum deflection varum? Definitely C ku D ku nadula da maximum deflection varum. ஆனா எக்ஸாக்டா எங்க வருதுன்னு நம்ம முதல்ல என்ன பண்ணணும்? கண்டுபிடிக்கணும். சோ டு ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் தட் பை கேஸ் பை ரீசனபிள் கேஸ் ஓகே த மேக்சிமம் டிஃப்ளக்ஷன் வில் லை பிட்வீன் சி அண்ட் டி. ஓகே, அப்போ எக்ஸ் எதுவாக தான் இருக்கும், it should be less than inge irundhu nammal x paakrom, inge irundhu x paakrom 3 ah vida adhigama irukano 7 ah vida kammiya irukano, ena indha point vandu 0 la irundhu enga irukku 3 la irukku, indha point vandu 0 la irundhu 7 la irukku, idu rendukku nadula da maximum deflection varapodu. Appo x vandu x location, adhaavadhu location where maximum deflection can happen. அது எப்படி இருக்கணும்? 3 விட அதிகமாகவும் 7 விட கம்மியாகவும் இருக்கணும். சோ x max வந்து சோ x max னே வெச்சுக்கோ. சோ x max location will be less than 7 and greater than 3. less than 7 and greater than 3. ஓகே. அப்படின்னா நீ மேக்ஸிமம் டிஃப்ளக்ஷன் டிஃப்ளக்ஷன் ஈக்குவேஷன்ல போயிட்டு லெஸ் தேன் த்ரீ போட்டேன்னா என்ன ஆகும்? இப்போ லெஸ் தேன் த்ரீ ஒரு வேல்யூ எடுத்துக்கோ, த்ரீ சாரி கிரேட்டர் தென் த்ரீ எடுத்துக்கோ, 3.1 எடுத்துக்கோ. 3.1 எடுத்தேன்னா யூ வில் ஹாவ் பாசிட்டிவ் வேல்யூ ஹியர். பட் இங்கே த்ரீல இருந்து 7 விட ஒரு பாயிண்ட் கம்மியாக எடுத்தேன்னா என்ன வரும்? 6.9 எடுத்தா கூட இங்கே வந்து யூ வில் கெட் அ நெகட்டிவ் வேல்யூ. அப்போ இந்த டைம் என்ன பண்ணிடலாம்? நம்ம நெக்லெக்ட் பண்ணிடலாம். நீங்க த்ரீல இருந்து செவன் வரைக்கும் எந்த பாயிண்ட் எக்ஸ் பதிலாக போட்டாலும் யூ வில் கெட் அ பாசிட்டிவ் வேல்யூ. ஸோ திஸ் வில் கம் இன் டு த எஃபெக்ட். ஆனால் இங்கே த்ரீல இருந்து செவனுக்குள்ள நீ எந்த வேல்யூ போட்டாலும் செவனுக்கு உள்ள எந்த வேல்யூ போட்டாலும் யூ வில் கெட் நெகட்டிவ். ஸோ திஸ் வில் பி நாட் ஹேவிங் த எஃபெக்ட் இன் த மேக்ஸிமம் ரிஃப்ளக்ஷன். ஸோ ஒய் கேன் பி கேல்குலேட்டட். ஓகே, ஸோ ஒய் கேன் பி கேல்குலேட்டட் ஒய் மேக்ஸ். ஓகே, பை by considering considering 30 into x cube by 3. okay, 30 into x cube by 3. அதுக்கு முன்னால we have to find out the location. I told you to find the exact location. What you supposed to do? What is the condition? The condition is that dy by dx is 0. The slope should be 0. So dy by dx is nothing but slope. அப்போ ஸ்லோப் ஈக்குவேஷன் எங்க இருக்கு? திஸ் இஸ் த ஸ்லோப் ஈக்குவேஷன். இந்த ஸ்லோப் ஈக்குவேஷன்ல ஸ்லோப் ஷுட் பி ஜீரோ. அண்ட் ஸ்லோப் ஜீரோவா இருக்கணும்னா எக்ஸ் என்னங்கிறத நம்ம கண்டுபிடிக்கணும். அப்போ ஸ்லோப் என்ன செஞ்சிடலாம்? டைரெக்டா ஜீரோ போட்டுடலாம். ஸோ ஜீரோ போட்டுட்டு லெஃப்ட் சைட் ஷுட் பி ஜீரோவா இருக்கணும்னா எக்ஸ் என்னவா இருக்கணும் அப்படின்னு நம்ம கண்டுபிடிக்கணும். ஸோ 30x2 யூ கெட் 30x2 மைனஸ் இங்கே இஃப் யூ சப்ஸ்டியூட் எனி வேல்யூ பிட்வீன் 3 to 7 யூ வில் கெட் பாசிட்டிவ். இங்கே சிமிலர்லி 3 to 7 எந்த வேல்யூ போட்டாலும் யூ வில் கெட் நெகட்டிவ். ஸோ திஸ் வில் பி ஜீரோ. ஸோ 20/3 இன்டூ எக்ஸ் மைனஸ் 3 த ஹோல் கியூப். ஸோ மைனஸ் 20/3 இன்டூ எக்ஸ் மைனஸ் 3 த ஹோல் கியூப். ஓகே, மைனஸ் 5/10. ஏன்னா இந்த டைம் வந்து கிடையாது, ஏன்னா அது நெகட்டிவ் டைம். மைனஸ் 5/10. ஓகே, ஸோ ஐ கிவ் யூ அ ஸ்மால் ஹோம் ஒர்க். ஓகே, ஸோ நவ் யூ ஹாவ் டு ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் த எக்ஸ் வேல்யூ. ஓகே, இட்ஸ் அ கியூபிக்கல் ஈக்குவேஷன். யூ ஹாவ் டு சால்வ் திஸ் கியூபிக்கல் ஈக்குவேஷன், ஃபைண்ட் த எக்ஸ் வேல்யூ வேர் யூ வில் ஹாவ் மேக்ஸிமம் டிஃப்ளக்ஷன். ஓகே, ஆஃப்டர் ஃபைண்டிங் த எக்ஸ் வேல்யூ சப்ஸ்டியூட் த எக்ஸ் வேல்யூ இன் த ஒய் ஈக்குவேஷன். இந்த ஈக்குவேஷன்ல அந்த எக்ஸ் வேல்யூ தூக்கி போட்டேன்னா யூ வில் கெட் ஒய் மேக்ஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ ஐ கிவ் யூ திஸ் ஒர்க் ஆஸ் அ ஹோம் ஒர்க். ஓகே, ஸோ பிஃபோர் யூ கம் ஃபார் த நெக்ஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் யூ கம்ப்ளீட் திஸ் ஒன் அண்ட் கிவ் மீ த ஆன்சர்ஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ வெரி சிமிலர். யூ ஹாவ் டு ஒன்லி திங் இஸ் யூ ஹாவ் டு சால்வ் திஸ் கியூபிக்கல் ஈக்குவேஷன். யூ யூஸ் ட்ரையல் அண்ட் எரர் மெத்தட், சப்ஸ்டிட்யூட் சம் எக்ஸ் வேல்யூ ஸோ தட் யூ வில் கெட் த ப்ராப்பர் zero for this expression. So that will be the x value where you will get the maximum. Okay, so do it as a homework. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me. You have any doubt? Yes or no?
No sir.
No sir. No, sir.